this presentation is done especially for this conference, and it's prepared with my colleague Khaled bin Abdallah. The motivation and for this work is about consumption of fossil fuels in the transport sector represents the fastest growing source of greenhouse gases. It's a major source leading to global warming. In Tunisia, for example, energy consumption of transport activity is still continues to increase with a share more than 34% of total energy consumption in 2010. The transport sector represents the 35% of the energy consumption in Tunisia. It has the second place after the industrial sector. And mainly in the transport sector, the major energy use is petroleum products. Petroleum products. For example, in 2010, the road transport sector had the highest energetic consumption, about 76% compared to other means of transport. And it's considered the important source responsible for combustible fuels consumption with about 99.4% of petroleum product consumption. Also, the transport energy is the major cause of environmental pollution. For example, the CO2 emission from road transport sector have increased from 1.75 million metric tons in 1980 to 4.94 million metric tons in 2010, representing more than 27% of total CO2 emissions. Road transportation affects environment by emitting greenhouse gases, and environment also affects road transportation through climate change. The transport sector has to meet many challenges. It has to fulfill the challenge of economy, society, and the environment. Nowadays, action is needed to restrict the use of fossil fuels. Tunisian government, for example, should elaborate a sustainable transport strategy that takes into account the rising of fossil fuels consumption and the negative effects of CO2 emissions at the same time. The measures normally used for sustainable transport are normally divided or classified into policy measures. Renewable energy development, such as biofuels, or the strategy of reduction of energy consumption based on the fossil fuels. But the restriction of transport related to energy consumption can be achieved only by using economic instruments such as fuel or carbon taxes. However, the strategy of reducing transport energy consumption can have negative effects on economic growth. Policymakers should be aware of the nexus between transport energy and economic growth for both energy and environmental policy. This is the objectives of this paper, to study the causal mechanism or relationship between transport value added of transport, road transport energy consumption, and CO2 emissions from Tunisian transport sector during the period of 1980 to 2010. The choice of transport sector is mainly guided by the strong connection between the environment and road transportation. Even the transport is based on the consumption of fossil fuel energy. Recently, interest in the causality question has gained more attention to the concerns about climate change, with following proposals to limit CO2 emissions by restricting fossil fuel consumption. And in the literature about the causality between energy consumption and economic growth, mainly it has some the original works of Kraft and Kraft 97, 97-8, and Kirk and Long 1980, with the empirical studies are based on the causal relationship between energy consumption and economic growth on aggregated level. Nowadays, there is a concern about the studies which focus mainly on the energy consumption, GDP and CO2 emissions, but on disaggregated level. What we do in this work, we focus on in this relationship. We propose an insight, which propose an insight for policymakers in the choice and the implementation of adequate strategy reducing road energy consumption. For example, if causality runs from road transport energy consumption to transport value added, then a policy based on restricting the use of energy may impede the transport GDP. However, if such causality direction runs only from transport GDP to road transport energy, then a conservation based on the conservation policy may be desirable. For the graphic analysis of the three variable used, the per capita road transport energy consumption, the first one, and the second, the per capita transport CO2 emissions, and the third, for per capita transport value added. As we see, the three variables have the same trend. From these graphics, we can show that there is a cointegration between the three series. Here, in the approach used is the Johansson cointegration approach, which is applied mainly in the four steps. The first step is by to test the stationarity of the variable using the ADF and Phillips-Perron tests. The second is to choose the lag length used in the cointegration test using the IC and SIC criteria. The third step is to test the cointegration using the cointegration test of trace test. And the third, to carry Granger causality tests based in the vector error correction model. For the results of the ADF and Phillips-Perron test, from the results we find that the three variables are stationary on the first difference, but on the level they are not stationary, that we deduce that they are integrated of order one. For the results of the choice of the lag, the IC criteria give for P equal to 4, and the Schwarz criteria give to for P equal to 1. Using the parsimony law, we choose the minimum of the two, which is P equal to 1. For the Johansson cointegration test, as we see the results, for the first hypothesis, the near hypothesis is rejected, which means that we cannot have zero cointegration. For this second, the hypothesis is accepted, and hence the conclusion there is a one vector cointegration between the three variables. Now this is the model applied, the vector error correction model applied normally before testing the causality. For the results of Granger causality, for the short run causality is given by the first results, and for the long run causality is given by the last column. As we see, for the short run causality, all the statistics, all coefficients are significant. sense, only one, which means that they, normally the transport value added, doesn't Granger cause the CO2 emissions in the short run. But for the other, there is usually a causality between the three variables. For the long run causality, only in the second equation, the error coefficient is not significant, which means that this the short run causality are in the first graphic, and the long run causality is in the second graphic, which means that there is unidirectional causality from per capita road transport energy consumption to per capita transport CO2 emissions, and a unidirectional causality from per capita road transport energy consumption to per capita transport value added, and there is a bidirectional between the per capita transport CO2 emissions and per capita transport value added. For the analysis, mainly the unidirectional causality between the road transport energy consumption and transport value added, we see that there is a causality from CO2 from energy consumption to transport value added, which means that if we reduce the energy consumption, we reduce also the value, the transport value added. And a policy which is based in reducing energy consumption, it's not good for normally for the value added or the economic growth. This is the main result, which means that politics will be based not on the reduction of energy consumption, but in finding or investing in renewable energy resources. For the unidirectional causality running from road transport energy consumption to transport CO2 emissions, this is an evident result. When there is a consumption, energy consumption, there are more pollution. For the third result also, the bidirectional causality between transport CO2 emissions and transport value added, this is also evident, as it's confirmed by the environmental Kuznets curve. When there is CO2 emissions, there is a negative effect on environment, and negative effect on environment affect also economic growth. This is the relation between climate change and economic growth in general. Policy application and conclusions, we can conclude that energy that Tunisia will invest in mainly in renewable energy sources, and the solution also to improve the energy efficiency in the transport sector. Thank you.